Hey everyone, and welcome to a new video. In this video we're going to talk about layers and transparencies, so how we can place images in a scene in a way that they are displayed in the correct order. So, let's begin. Before we start though, I want to show you where I'm getting those images. This is from this website, glitchthegame.com, public domain game art. This is a game that was existing in 2009 until 2012. And it's now discontinued, but all the assets created for the game are now shared for public usage, so we can download them and use them in our max patches or whatever we want to use them for. I will put the link in the description. So first thing we need to do in our patch is to create a JIT world, since we're going to work with the OpenGL objects. I'm going to call the context main. I'm going to give it full scale anti-aliasing to avoid the aliasing. And then I'm going to say floating one to not let the window go behind our patcher. Then I'm going to say size 320 by 240. I'm going to put it enabled by default. And I think that's it. Great. So now we are going to import some images from these assets that I just showed you. And we're going to do that with a JIT matrix, to which we send a message import movie, right? And let's connect a JIT window just to display what we are importing. So I'm going to click here, import movie. A couple of images got on my desktop, for example, the glitch garden. And then we need actually to send a bang to this matrix in order to display the image we just imported. Cool. Since it's a bit annoying to always send a bang to the matrix, we can also just automatically bang it once it's finished importing. So, for example, every time we import something, the second output of JIT matrix will output the message import movie 1. So what I'm going to do is to create a zeta etchils with an argument of 1, which basically is going to give us from the second output the latest element of this message that comes out from JIT matrix. So let's give it a try. Right, so it gives us the one portion of this message, so the latest element of this list. And I'm going to say select one. So once it's finished importing, it's going to automatically bang the matrix. So let's try, for example, with another image. Right, so as you can see, it's working. Cool, this will spare us to always bang after importing. Good, then I'm going to send this image as a texture to a GGL video plane that draws to our main context, and let's transform reset too, because I want it to occupy the whole screen. So let's give it a try. Yeah, the widget world is already enabled. So yeah, our background is occupying the whole rendering window. Pretty good. Now let's copy this whole thing another time, because I want to import some other images. But this one, I don't want it to have any transform reset, so I'm just going to delete the attribute, which basically is the same as writing transform reset 0. And I'm going to import another image, which is a glitchgarden3.l. Now, as you can see, we cannot see this image in our rendering window, this video plane, because the first video plane that we render here is rendered on top of the other video plane. So it's basically covering it. It's like if it's on top of it. So this is our first video plane, we call it background. And the second one, it's like if it's behind it, right? So of course we don't see it, since it's behind the other video plane. Cool. So in order to make it appear, we can, since we are anyway working with video planes, so basically we are working in 2D, because these are just flat images, first of all, we could give the attribute ortho2 to the JIT world object, and this means that we don't care anymore about the z-axis. Oh, and when we do that, you can see that now we see the image, and that's because every time we destroy and recreate the JIT world, it's going to reinitialize the whole GL context, which means now they are rendered in a different order, but this is mostly casual. We could not know if this image was going to appear or not. So now, if we want to be sure that this image is always on top, what we can do is to set the attribute depth enabled to 0, which means now our rendering system, it's not going to care anymore about the zeta position of this object. It doesn't matter anymore, this value is discarded. What it's going to care about is only the layer attribute. So if I say layer 2, it means that I'm basically moving this image on top of the other image, so the video plane on top of the other video plane, so to show it kind of in a 3D way. Our image was before rendered in a layer that was below our first one, our BG one. And if we set the layer to be bigger than the layer of the BG, it means that now the image is drawn on top of it. So that's what is happening. Now the proportions of this image are not correct, because we should say preserve aspect 1 if we want the proportions to be correct. Exactly, that's how our tree looks like. Now if we go to check how this tree image looks like, looks like this, we can see that there's actually a white background. That's because this image actually has an alpha channel. So in order to visualize the alpha channel, we should give to this GGL video plane the blend enable attribute. So we say blend enable 1. And now we can see that we are seeing the image with the alpha channel used, because all the 3D objects in Max use alpha blend by default. We can check this when we check the blend attribute. Alpha blend is automatically selected. Great. So the lesson is, if we want to display objects in Max that have an alpha channel, we mostly want to use the depth enable 0, because probably we want to display first the objects that are opaque, like for example our background, and then we want to display all the objects that have an alpha channel. So we say depth enable 0, because for the objects that have the alpha channel, we don't care about the z-axis, we just want to render them on top of every opaque object. That's why we use the layer attribute to set them on a layer greater than the opaque objects. And then blend enable to activate the blending. Cool. Let's now change the position of this tree to put it kind of on the left side of our screen. Great. Let's create another one of those. This will be our right tree. So I'm going to import the image with the right tree. Great. As you can see, it's already rendered correctly because all the attributes stayed the same. Cool. As you can see, when I change the size of the window, of course, it changes the position of those images, because the background image is actually full HD. So every time we resize the rendering window, it doesn't have anymore the correct proportions, unless we give the preserve aspect also to this video plane. Let's see how this works. Right, cool. So now it's always going to render it with the correct proportions. Exactly. So now every time we resize the rendering window, is anyway keeping the background image with the current aspect ratio, so we can set a position for our trees, and this will always be correct. Cool, let's try another thing. Let's import another image using again the same system. So it's getting a bit crowded with video planes here. So I'm just going to with import movie. I downloaded a bunch of these assets from the website that I showed you. So I'm just going to get one like this, Awesome Stew. Right, it's very big. So let's actually going to rescale it with a scale attribute. Let's actually do like this. Create a scale message, $1 to set the value, and then we can rescale it. Cool. Let's actually check also its layer attribute, just to make it even super clear. If we make this layer attribute equal to 0, which is the same layer by default of our background, every 3D object by default has a layer of 0, you can see that the image disappears. But if we make it just slightly bigger than the layer of the background, you can see that the image then appears. And then if we move it, for example, behind a tree, since our trees have a layer of 2, we can see that the ball is between the background and the trees. But if we will make this a layer of 2, then it will be on the same level of the trees, so it's actually then above them. Or we can make it even a bigger layer, so it's always above them. But if we want to be behind the tree, then we have to give it at least one level of layers below the trees. And cool, this is of course valid also for 3D shapes that we create directly in Max, like for example GGL grid shape, draws to main, let's say depth enable 0, there it is, let's scale it a bit. As you can see, it's disappeared because it's kind of random. If you don't decide a layer, then it's kind of random if this object gets drawn before other objects in the patch or after them. So if we set a layer, then this will always be on top of everything. So let's change its position also. Right. Cool. So great. I hope this was useful and clear enough. Let me know if there are still some doubts or something that was unclear in the comments. If you wish, you can also check my Patreon page to download this patch and check all my other shared patches and tutorials there. And anyway, I will see you in the next video. Have fun, everyone. See you soon.